David, yeah, he's free. I said John, but I meant David. You know, I'm getting older. Yeah. Ladies and gentlemen, these three people and their teams behind them, and that is very important. There are teams behind them. Presented us this wonderful Jet World Master. Thank you. You know, Roger Shipley was with us the great night in 1995 when we had the very first one in Neu-Ulm. And Roger promised me, someday we will all be in the USA to have another Jet World Masters, and I know he worked very, very hard on this. Teresa, to tell you a secret, I love her. David, those two girls and guys, you are so fantastic. You know, when I got a rumor before I left here for my trip to come here, I got a rumor the marquee was blowing off. And for me it was a nightmare, because we had the same situation, you remember, in Northern Ireland. But the very, very different ball. In Northern Ireland, they sat down, start crying, and said, no, it's over. These people sat together and said, we will make it. And they did it within 2 days. Thank you very, very much. We had, I met Teresa, I met Roger, I met David, and I felt the spirit behind those people. When I came home, I was asked in Germany, in Europe, will this be a good Jet World Masters? Because of all the experience we had in Northern Ireland, especially in Israel, and everybody asked me, will this be a good Jet World Masters? And is it worth to spend a lot of money to come over here? And I said, yes, 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 yes. And here we are. So now, for you, it's a day to honor you, and it's a time to bring you a small present for you and for teams. And I will ask the team Belgium to come up to say hello and to bring their presents to our organizers. Where are they? Vanished. Philip, team manager Philip Abbott. And don't forget the spirit, we need labor here. Philip, come on. It's your microphone.
Ladies and gentlemen, we are so proud that these people have organized this event for us. This is truly magnificent, also this environment in the museum, Nation's Night at the museum. It's just wonderful, it's such a beautiful thing. We will always remember that, and we are very grateful for that. We only brought a very small present, some chocolates and cookies from Belgium, but I hope we appreciate it. You appreciate it.
Philip, Philip, don't forget the spirit here. They forget it. They didn't bring any spirit. So I think we have a new candidate for the year. Next team is Canada with Martin Fabre. He also entered the very, very first Jet World Masters in 1995. Thank you for being again here.
Selon que les pays plus grands, on donne peu ou beaucoup.
Hello, everyone. My team is very proud to be here. This is really a unique place in the world for people who love airplanes. And to have a Jet Roll Master here is just outstanding. And we want to express our appreciation to the organizer for hosting this event here. We have an Air Force Museum in China, but it's nowhere near as beautiful as this, but hopefully one day we'll catch up. Anyway, we have brought with us some souvenirs from China. This is a model of the Chinese J-10 fighter, and I'd like to present that to the museum. And for the organizer, we have bought a special gift. This is a beautiful Chinese opera mask. It might scare you. And Roger, you know, he speaks with such an outstanding voice. I think he might like to put this on when he announces us. We also brought with us some Chinese baijiu or white spirits, you know, it's better than jet fuel. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
To tell you a secret, it's like kerosene. Next team is England. This is team leader James Bentor. Where are you?
Good evening. Well, on behalf of our very large team, just Dunphy and myself, I'd like to thank everybody for the hospitality here and the organisation, which has been absolutely fantastic. We're having a wonderful time, and we were asked to bring a gift, and we forgot. So, on the way into the museum, we managed to find something suitable, which we found on the wall back there. It's a very nice picture of a hawk, which is the model that we're flying, or very similar. It represents the best of the British aerobatic team. And, I'll just show you actually. You see the patch on the wall down the corridor on the left-hand side. Well, I'll present it. I think they'll find that looks very nice on the mantelpiece at home. So on behalf of the British team, I'd like to thank everybody who supported us, and let's have a really nice evening. Thank you. Well, there's still some spirit for the International Combat Drinking Club that's going on here, gentlemen. Next team is Germany. It's team leader David Christen.
Yeah, good evening everybody. So here's our spirits for the combat drinking. So the German team would also like to thank the organization, Roger Chipley, and the museum. It's a fantastic event, it's a great setup. You have done a wonderful job, and we have a nice present for you. It's a German Air Force Tornado on a memorial plate. So, thank you very much. We really enjoy being here. I think it's the greatest atmosphere we ever had for a Nations Night, being surrounded by those planes. So, I just have to say thank you for that. It's just great. And we have one more person the German team would like. We have one more person the German team would like to say a special thank you. And I would like to have Larry Tudor come up to the stage, please. Larry, come up to us. Larry Tudor has been coming to the Jet World Masters, I guess ever since. He has been at the Jet World Masters, number two in England, and ever since he has been there. And he's just a heart of jet flying, and he supported us, being an American. He supported the German team with all the logistics. He brought everything we need. He brought, you can't imagine what he did for us. He brought printer, he brought coolers, he brought tools, he just brought everything we need. Larry, a special thank you from the German team to you. Yes.
I've known this guy for a long, long time, and I'm glad he finally made a contribution. All right, thanks. Winnie, your turn.
Thank you very much. And I tell you, he has the hardest job on this airfield to bring always enough beer for the Germans.
So if you're a thirsty, come to the German edge in the big marquee. Next team is Hungary with Zoltán Pál. And so on, but he is here with us, and they gave us a wonderful Jet World Masters in Hungary some time ago. Thank you again for that.
I'm coming to you, boys.
I wish you good evening, everybody. First of all, I would like to grant this Hungarian, nice Hungarian book to the special organizer of this event, Mr.
Roger.
You can see a lot of pictures on that about Hungary, about Budapest, and a lot of important cities in Hungary. Of course. We wish you a super race separately. A nice gift to the Mr.
Thomas
from the museum.
Special.
This is a special Hungarian.
Thank you.
Ring. And we would like to thank you for all the United States organizers for the help they gave us during our competition. It's very pity that the Hungarian team cannot compete in this DBM 2011 because with our problems with the plane. But I would like to mention that a lot of staff, a lot of members give us a lot of help to try to fix our problems with the plane. And thank you very much. I have a special thanks to Dewey, to Roger, who tried to make everything for us to fix our plane, but now we are out of the competition. But we become spectators, and we wish you good luck to everybody. One thing is missing from this event. I think that most of you remember from the GVM in Hungary. It's missing. What is missing? Good goulash. Thank you very much, everybody.
Just to give you a reminder, when we left Hungary, every nation signed this flag. And I would like to ask you to do the same, so you all have flags from your country here. So please let all pilots, our helpers, sign that flag, and then at the end of this competition, we will give it to the museum. Just to give you a reminder. Next team is Italy, with my old friend Alessandro Rosina. He was also with us at the very first Jet World Masters 1995 in Neu-Ulm.
Hello to everybody. Hey, you Americans. You are really master in many, many things, like aerospace, aircraft, but also electronics, computer, but there is one thing you are really far away, and I mean the brown sauce you call coffee. So here you have the right tools to make some practice. One original mocha, a one word in a real coffee. So you can try to learn a little bit more.
This is
great! Thank you. Put it in front. Yes, we have more. That's fine. Thank you very much, Sandro. Next team is from the Netherlands with Ben Jensen. And he did all the scoring, all the computer work for you. And he is with us for a lot of Jetworld Masters, and he will also be with us in the future. Mr. Computer, Ben Jensen.
Okay, ladies and gentlemen, we have here on stage the complete Dutch team, and it's a team with a lot of history. First of all, First of all, we have here General Griffin. He was there in the first and the second Jetworld Masters in Noyon. And now he's back, and I must say with a very beautiful airplane. I hope you all seen it and made all the pictures. We have a new pilot, Derek. He was in Ireland, but unfortunately he could not compete. Airplane was not ready. But this time he's there, and he's doing a great job with a small F-16, and it looks great. Great afterburner also, by the way. And last, but certainly not least, the man you everybody will know from the last 5-6 Jetworld Masters. And guess what? This time, he flew!
Yay! Yay!
Okay, so on behalf of the Dutch team, I really want to thank Roger and also Julie, of course, for organizing this event. I've been with Jetworld Masters since Hungary. I did Ireland, I did Israel, and especially the last two were definitely interesting. This one is going smooth. So thanks to Roger, and also thanks to the team from the museum for organizing a very great event that up to now had, well, started with a little bit of a big disaster. They recovered quickly, and I must say, for me, this is the best one in the long run, really. So I brought some gifts from the Netherlands, and, you know, keeping in mind that we are going to America, what to bring. You know, when you go to Russia, you bring Geneva and other alcohols and stuff. You know, what do you bring to America? Well, you just look at what do Americans know about the Netherlands. And pretty much, there's three things. Roger says he knows, so let's see what he knows.
Tulips, of course!
Tulips! There we go, we got tulips. But there's only one out of three. What else do we have in the Netherlands that we are so famous for, and it's not cheese this time, because we can't import that.
It's not cheese.
Go ahead, I'm
Women's shoes. Women's shoes is the correct answer, and we have a winner. And we'll go straight to number three also, because Elf is going to be here all night. The third one would be windmills, of course, and they're painted on the wooden shoes.
Hey, Merlin, you want the tulips? Can you put the tulips on?
And, you know, Sandra already took care of it, you know. The coffee part is taken care of, but just a cup of coffee is pretty, you know, bare, lonely, not nice. So what you need is really Dutch stroopwafels. Cookies, for that matter.
Oh, cookies, all right.
All right. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much. For the Dutch team. Next team is a team who had at the very beginning of Jet World Masters bad luck. You know, all of these guys prepared for years to come here. They spend a lot of money and you know, when you're here you want to compete and nothing else. And you know, you all heard of the bad disaster we had, and the next team, they had really bad luck because one aeroplane was destroyed. But then, the spirit of the IGMC and the spirit of this Jet World Masters glow up. Immediately, the American team offered the South African team an aeroplane, so Mark Savage can attend here, and I said a hearty welcome to the team from South Africa. With the team leader, Martino Spottier.
South Africa came with a lot of expectations, and it didn't quite work out the way we planned it to work out. But there's some people around here, and I'm not going to mention names, because if I leave anybody out, I can just say that we have never, ever been treated so well when disaster struck. Especially David, Teresa, Roger. I just want to mention maybe one or two names, Jim, Andy, Lance, Dewey, all the guys that was there on Sunday afternoon that helped us. It's amazing. We've never experienced anything like that, and all I can say to you guys is thank you very, very much. Then, to Scott Harris, I just want to clear something with the American team. He did not loan us the plane. We bought it for $1, and when we leave, we're going to sell it back to him for $1. So there's no hard feelings to the American team. And then Winnie, we're not sure whether we can do this, but then suggested that we file a protest tonight.
No!
You must listen to it. We protest against Team Russia that started practicing early for the combat zinc. We thought there's no practicing allowed. Again, we brought you guys just some handcraft from Africa, and it's all handmade by the local population in some tablecloths and some glassware. Thank you very, very much.
You know, you heard the next team had a secret practice lesson at the very beginning here. I know tomorrow in the evening we arrange a little field party, and they asked me 20 liters of vodka, is that enough? I said no. Team from Russia with the team leader Viktor Lashmanov.
Thank you very much for your hospitality. Thank you very much for your patience, because we are Russian, little bit crazy.
Oh no, a whole lot.
That's all. We love you all. really, we love you and we love America. You know, I told before, Russians are a little bit crazy, but nevertheless, we are like all other people, believe me. And I hope to see you all some days in Russia. We brought with us some souvenirs, and when you are in Russia, you will see that no beers run along the streets. That's real Russian honey. Russian beer. Special offer. Drinking special Russian vodka, pilot's vodka. Don't miss it. Thanks a lot. See you in Russia.
Victor, I figured you out. For a whole week now, you pretended like you don't understand English, and you just spoke perfectly. So there will be no more of that.
Oh, man.
Next team are our friends from Switzerland, with the team leader, Edgar Bruhin.
Actually, it's a great honor, ladies and gentlemen, to stay here in front of the big US flag you see behind. Switzerland is a very small country, so our flag is this size. But if you compare the problems in the US to the Swiss, it might be the same size right now. That's why, especially to the US, really what you have done, it's really a great applause. I guess only very few know that tonight it's actually the nation's night, but on the 1st August in Switzerland, we have the Swiss National Day. So on the 1st August 1291, they came three men together and said, we are going to fight against the aggressors. So today we have our 720 years anniversary of Switzerland. And usually at this day, we start huge firework. As we can't do it right now here in the museum, we are going to do it tomorrow. So we have a celebration with the Americans together. Switzerland is known also for several things: chocolate, cheese, watches, etc., etc., etc. I brought them for the beginning, for this time, some chocolate. But as you know, in almost 48 hours, we are going to do our presentation, and I hope that everybody here in will be in Switzerland and we will have a great fun again. And finally, we are a small country, a small flag. But as I can see here in the round, we are actually the biggest team of almost 35 people. So all the Swiss give to the others a big hand clap.
Thank you very much. It's really great to be here in America with all of our friends.
Thank you, Edgar.
More.
Thank you very much. Next team is a team from Taiwan with his team leader Barry Hu.
Thank you all very much. We're so happy to be here. This is, for me personally, this is my very first Jet World Masters. And throughout the months, we had some plays and we received overwhelming support from everyone. And today we met Chinese team, Mr. Simon Tao, a fantastic team leader, captain, and a gentleman. And we were very happy to have met Mr. Simon Tao. And we're also very happy to be here, and we thank Roger, Teresa, Dave, and everybody else involved in this event. And now we have some gifts.
Hello, dear friends. From the fantastic organizer team, we would like to present one gift from the Taiwan National Palace Museum. It's a painting made by pure gold.
Whoa! You can have the chocolate.
Whoa! Got the chocolate.
Whoa!
In Chinese, it means very prosperous or very successful. So it's a very meaningful one. So hope you like it.
Oh yeah.
Oh yeah.
Another gift is for this fantastic, beautiful museum. We never have this experience come to such a beautiful museum here, and especially have them experience the dining with the F-22, the aircraft. So we're going to present this gift to, this gift is also a painting from Qing Dynasty, and it's also made by pure gold too.
Then, Super Jet A1 A7.
Thank you very much again.
Now the next team gave us a wonderful Jet World Masters. For all of us, it was at first an adventure, and then it was a fantastic time we had. And all of us remembered on that. The next team came from Thailand with Shira Ratanarat as the team leader.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. It is for me a great honor to be here, you know, as the aeroplane lovers and collectors, and about passion about airplane, because I'm telling my family, I can't live without anything but not without an athlete. And I have to go back to my old age. I got this passion even more when I was growing up in Germany. And the location was in Stuttgart. And you know that Stuttgart is almost the center of the motor airplane, you know, including Graupner companies, Multiplex, and other companies located in that area. So during my time as a student, I had a chance to become the RC flyer, and my first RC teacher was the chief, I call it English, redacteur. He's the chief, chief editor of the model magazine, Mr. Hans Dieter Heck. He was my RC teacher. And after that, I went home and I brought all the knowledge about RC motor airplane home, and I started to fly RC plane in Thailand and so on and so on. And then I came to the first jet master in Ulm. By that time I was unknown to the organizer, so I stood outside of the fence looking all the competitors with the fantastic plane. And I bought the first jet engine that was developed by Dr. Schlecklin. It was a sensation in Thailand to see the first jet plane flying in Thailand. And after that, I learned to know Winnie. And I thought, why not, after I organized many virtual and chip events for the radio control cars, why not to organize also a jet event? And it was possible to organize in 2001 in Pattaya. But I would say it was not quite good compared with this place in Dayton, Ohio. The location is fantastic. And Dayton, Ohio is always in my mind to come here to have a look at the best and the largest collection of the old airplane. So, and then coming back to our plane, we are flying our own developed Alpha Jet. I would say it may be the first turbine Alpha Jet of the world. So I have to thank the organizer that I have the chance to show our first developed Alpha Jet. And regarding Alpha Jet, also I have a good memory with Germany, because I was the person who conducted this transaction between the two governments. And Thai Air Force received about 15 Alpha Jets at a fantastic price. €1 per unit. But our Air Force must pay the transport to Thailand. So thank you very much again for all the organizers. You have done a marvelous job. So, and I hope one day maybe I can have an opportunity to organize again with a better quality. So thank you very much. And I have some a small gift from Thailand. You know, Thailand has not only the tourist places, but also we are quite well known in the handmade silk, mostly made by Thai women. So I would like to hand over
to the lady.
Thank you very much. Thank you.
Thank you very much.
And dear friend Chira, I can tell you a secret. When we went to Thailand, there were some guys with us, they never saw the airfield. Christopher, are you here from Trinidad Tobago? Are you here? Come on. These guys
had bad luck. You know, if you fly airplanes, sometimes you run into a disaster. And all the preparations of these beautiful guys were gone when they crashed their airplanes just before the jet boat passes. Christopher sent me an email and said, unfortunately, we are out, but it's such a good place here. I will come definitively, and that's Christopher. Thank you so much.
I'm nervous. I didn't expect to be here because, you know, 4 days before the event, I took my last flight just to make sure everything goes well, and unfortunately it didn't. And we all know the story, you know, that last flight is always the critical one. Well, it happened to me, but, you know, my vacation was based on being here, and boy, am I nervous. But in any ways, I spoke to a lot of the committees, and they all told me that, you know, you could come here and hang out with the guys and see what they're like. And I gotta admit that this place is amazing, and it's, you know, there's no words to say how grateful I am to be here. But unfortunately, on my behalf, I'm very embarrassed to say that I didn't bring a gift. But, you know, in Trinidad, the weather is always good, and I can say that I hope that I brought at least some sunshine here for everybody, just at least that Trinidad is here. I got my parents here with me and my son, and we grew up around aviation. So I am very happy and honored to be here, that the committee allowed me to come anyways. But unfortunately, you know, I cannot compete with you among the best of the best. And I see here that everybody is a winner. No matter you're up or down, we're all winners. This is a great sport. I hope I will be there in Switzerland. My flag is smaller than this one here. It's a little dot on the map. So I will bring the little dot. So thank you again, and to the committee. I am very sorry. I hope my smile makes up for everything. Thank you very much.
Christopher, this shows us the real spirit, and I think my Swiss friends will not be against that, but take this home and bring it back to Switzerland. Yes, ladies and gentlemen, last but not least, our fantastic team from the United States of America, with the team leader, Tommy Yates.
Without the help of a lot of people out there and Roger and these people, it could have never happened. And this is an absolutely phenomenal place. You know, when I graduated high school several years ago, I would have never thought that I'd be drinking vodka with the Russians in this building. And this is just a wonderful event that makes one big family. And we've made so many friends here. And there's guys out here in the crowd who we fly with at the jet event, and we fly with Roger. And, you know, we love these guys, and they're the ones who are responsible for helping us be here. We don't have anything really to give them except for our thanks and our love and our appreciation. And, you know, we want to tell you how wonderful it is for you guys to be here with us to celebrate this event. And we look forward to being in Switzerland in 2 years, and maybe one day in Trinidad, and maybe one day in Moscow. And if there's anything that we can do to help make your vacation and your time here better, please let us know. Thank you very much. We want this for the drinking club, but you guys talked too long, so there's only half left.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
Hey, look, guys, you could have saved me a seat at the table for me and my wife at your table. Thanks a lot.
Thank you to all the teams, and you see, we have here a good land of spirits. And Nations Night would not be a Nations Night without the test of new members for the International Combat Drinking Club. We come to this later, so I'm waiting for your to get some names. We need 5 candidates from all our countries, from everywhere, so come to me. But I think now let's have a little bit of rest, take a drink, stand up, speak together, have fun, and we will be back in the next half an hour. But Roger, you want to say something? Okay.
First off, I want to thank my wife for 16 years of preparing for this. Marilyn, would you please stand up? She's wondering when she might get me back, and I hope she remembers that maybe I'm a keeper, but we'll find out. In any case, I'm not going to tell you how long we've been married. She's my first and only wife, and fortunately I'm her only first and only husband. I'm very proud of her to be here, and we're really proud for all of you to be here. Dewey, where are you? Dewey Davenport. Dewey, please stand up. Some spots around Chicago, but I wouldn't have any luck with all the full scale. I knew Chicago would be attractive and still get to the museum. And by coincidence, Dewey called me and said, would you want to consider hosting it at the museum? I said, oh, yeah, sure, that's really. He knew the museum folks. That was about 3 years ago, Dewey, I think or so. And so a lot of fundraising, a lot of the organization, a lot of the local contacts, like the lunches and, you know, the fuel, and seeing his environment as a pilot that he's brought to the table. And so we all need to give him a real, real round of applause.
Thank you.
If there wasn't one here previously, I'd be remiss if I didn't recognize the staff of about 15. Some are still, most are still here, a few are gone. Some are coming in and couldn't spend 2 weeks. But my staff, please stand up and take a bow. All the staff members, please stand up. But the Marshall family is from Indiana. It's him, his wife and daughter. They've worked with it. So thank you very, very much. They spent many, many hours, many, I think it's 27 days, several of these fellows have spent at their own time, at their own cost, without any financial compensation, except for the love of the hobby and putting on a show. Thank you. The wonderful military museum in the world with 400 aircraft, a new hangar being built for all the presidential aircraft that are just off of this, thousands of artifacts, and it belongs to us, the public, the citizens of the United States. It's free for entrance, it's free for parking, you cannot charge a gate, and I'd like to give you Teresa Montgomery, the Director of Special Events.
The United States Air Force, we are proud and honored to have all of you here tonight. I am amazed at what I've seen over the last few weeks. I have been in the special event business for over 20 years here at the museum. And I must tell you that there are many people that come and want to do events at the museum, and we must tell them no, because we just don't have the ability to do all of the events people would like us to do. And about 4 years ago, Dewey Davenport had enough nerve to come into my office. First he went to David, and he asked David, he said, David, do you think the museum would be willing to host the Jet World Masters? And I have to tell you, I did not know what Jet World Masters was at that time. And Dewey, with all of his passion and love of aviation, took the time to come in with David and ask me if I'd be willing to seek approval for this. He spent a lot of time teaching me what it was, and when I realized that this was a world-class event that brought teams from all over the world to compete and find the Jet World Master for that event, I said, you know what, we have to do this. And I went to my boss, who was a General Metcalf at the time, and he's always telling me that I get him into all kinds of things. But I told him, I said, sir, I have to tell you, I think this is an event that is very important for us to do. I don't know of any place else in the world that would appreciate flyers like we do. And I don't know any flyers that would have more fun at any location than the National Museum of the Air Force. So David, who I have to tell you, David is truly the power behind this event. I am the person that puts out big fires. I'm the person that solves big problems. But David worked on this event for 4 years with Dewey and then Roger and then Winnie. And I mean, he worked on it day and night. I would go into his office. He would have big papers hanging from the windows with all his little thoughts on them. He would have diagrams. He built, in his brain, he built the judging table, the table where we had the aircraft judge. He thought of that. He would go home, and I don't even think he slept at night. And he worked for years, because to him, this was a passion. He wanted to do it right. And sometimes I just had to make him go home, because he would work so very hard. I'm very, very proud to have him on our team here at the museum. And when we're done with this event, he has three more flying events he must work. We're gonna bring in a C-130E that's gonna land on the same field back here where you're flying now. We're going to have a World War I fly-in where we will bring in World War I airplanes, and then we will also have a giant scale radio control fun fly on Labor Day weekend. So he was not just working one job, he was working many jobs. And I tell you, I don't know of anybody that could have been a better team than he and Dewey when it comes to ideas and making it happen. Dewey, I'm proud to have been part of this. Thank you for thinking of us. And then he brought Roger to the table. Thank you for allowing us to be part of this. Then we met Roger, then we met Winnie, and I have to tell you, we knew that this was going to be a great event. So what I want to say to you is this. I know many of you have worked very hard for several years to get your aircraft here. You've spent a lot of your own money. You've taken time that could be spent any place in the world you wanted to go. And you have come here to the National Museum of the Air Force. And I thank you. I appreciate you coming here. The museum is honored to have you. And I hope you all come back next year for vacation again. Thanks.
Or you go to the Russians, they have enough vodka with it. And later on I come back, so I'm still waiting for five names for new members for the International Combat Drinking Club. Have fun, I will be back in half an hour. Bye-bye.
Like aviator.
Right.
This is really nice.
Yeah.
Vodka. Yes.
Yeah.
It's right. Special for strong spirit.
Strong
people.
Spirit. Yeah. Aviator. Aviator are these watches you see here.
Yes, yes. Yeah, it's especially for good guys. This is.
Da hat doch schon jemand, oder? Da auch. Don't drink and fly.
Irgendwann brechen wir das natürlich ab, weil wir die Jungs nicht kaputt machen wollen. Und dann kommt das Schönste, wenn das alles vorbei ist, darf jeder von der ganzen Blase hier einmal an den Schlaf probieren. Und ich garantiere euch eins, dauert noch anderthalb Stunden, sind die alle blau.
Bini, Bini, er macht Bini.
I'm going to go to the next one.